Hey guys, this week's video is all about grey hair. We're going to be talking about many different things. We're going to be talking about what causes grey hair. We're going to be talking about premature greying, so premature grey hair. And then we're going to talk about different lifestyle things that you can do that could potentially help to stop grey hairs from forming, especially if it's happening prematurely, okay? So we're going to talk about all these different topics in this week's video. So this is going to be a relatively long video, jam-packed full of information. So if at any point you want to find any specific information, feel free to click on that description below. It's all been chaptered, you can find what you want. Also, please remember, if you find anything in this video helpful, if you learned something new from it today, if you just enjoyed watching it, please do click that like button. It's going to help me and it's going to help the video perform better so more people can watch it and become aware of what's causing the grey hair and what to do in terms of remedies and treatments for grey hair. So let's begin with the science of grey hair. On our scalp, we've got millions of hair follicles. You've probably seen them, they're bulb shaped and then the hair comes out of them. From the hair follicle, it contains something called melanin, and the melanin gives it the color, it gives the hair the color, and after a while, as we age, that color goes down, it gets bleached, and then the hair becomes gray. Now, the process of hair changing color from a darker color to a whiter color is all usually due to age and mostly due to our genetics. So you need to look at your parents and think, when did they start going gray? And then you can kind of see a correlation between yourself as well. So in terms of the hair changing color, within those hair follicles, we have a byproduct that's made called hydrogen peroxide. I'm sure you've all heard of it. And like I said, that bleaching is caused by the hydrogen peroxide. This is what's going to change the color. Now, we also have an enzyme called catalase, and catalase breaks down the hydrogen peroxide and stops it from changing the color of the hair. Now, usually something, usually due to genetics or other causes, as we get older as well, that catalase is reduced, okay? And when the catalase is reduced, we get more hydrogen peroxide, which then causes more hair to go gray with time. So now that we've looked at the science, let's talk about what is causing the hair to go gray, because it's not only due to age and genetics, there's many different factors as well that we're now gonna discuss. So the first cause that I wanna talk to you about is vitamin deficiency. In 2015, a study was done where they found various different deficiencies from B6 to B12 to biotin to vitamin D to vitamin E, and these were linked to premature graying of the hair. So, vitamin deficiencies could be a cause of premature graying of the hair. Now, it's important to remember this doesn't mean go out and buy loads of multivitamins, but it is an important thing that you can discuss with your healthcare professional as well, and actually think to yourself, could there be a cause for me to have these vitamin deficiencies? Because if you are having a healthy, balanced diet, most likely there won't be a cause. But one of the other things that I'm gonna talk to you later on about this in this video is about your gut biome as well, the bacteria in your gut. Now, this isn't proven yet with gray hair, but it could potentially be a contributor as well into the different deficiencies that we might have within our body. So the next cause I want to talk to you about is genetics. We spoke about it a little, but also I want to talk to you about a few studies. Some studies have shown that Caucasian people can gray prematurely as early as the age of 20, okay? And it's also been shown in studies as well that Asian and African American people can get premature graying from the age of 25 to 30 as well. Now, some medical conditions as well can cause premature graying and graying of the hair. So for example, autoimmune diseases. If you have any autoimmune diseases, it can potentially cause premature graying. And also any other medical conditions like thyroid conditions, this can also cause it. Now, with regards to the autoimmune conditions, again, I'm gonna talk about the gut biome a little later in terms of treatment options that we can try. Now, again, this isn't something that's proven, but there are some really interesting studies out there now talking about the gut biome. And biome, by the way, means your gut bacteria. So the bacteria within the gut and making sure you've got the good bacteria in your gut and potentially leading to helping with the premature graying and reducing the hair graying. Now, again, we're gonna talk about it later. We'll get to that once we've done the causes. Now, moving on to stress, there's conflicting evidence about stress. Some people believe that stress isn't contributing to premature graying of the hair, and some scientists believe that it is. There are some studies showing either way, so it's a bit of a 50-50 split. However, again, leading this on, linking this onto your gut biome and the gut bacteria, stress can also be a contributor of making gut biomes, making the gut bacteria worse within your system, and then helping it by having too much stress, it's gonna help all the bad bacteria increase, which could then release them toxins that are gonna potentially then cause more gray. These are one of the theories out there. There's loads of theories, but it's the theory that I'm starting to fall in with, and I feel like there's a lot of research to be done in this, and I'm going to talk about gut biome a bit later again. I keep saying this to you. I feel like I keep teasing you, but I just want to finish the causes first. Now, moving on to the next cause, which is smoking. A study was done which showed that if you're a smoker, you're 2.5 times more likely to get premature graying by the age of 30, okay, which is a massive contributor. So not only does smoking cause various cancers, lung cancer, heart disease, all of these problems that it causes, but it now also has been linked to graying, okay? So if there's any reason for you to stop smoking, far from all the other reasons, graying should be on top of it now as well. Moving on to the next cause, which is oxidative stress. And oxidative stress, and you've probably heard of antioxidants before, is basically free radicals within the body are causing damage to the cells. All these free radicals are bouncing off the different cells and causing damage and potentially causing premature graying. So too many free radicals is a bad thing, and that's why we need antioxidants to get rid of these as well, to restore a balance and reduce that premature aging and damage that's going to potentially cause graying of the hair. And the final cause is some chemical hair dyes. Even some shampoos and products that you put in hair can increase your risk of getting gray hair. For example, a lot of hair dyes and hair bleachers can contain hydrogen peroxide, which again we spoke about earlier, which if you're putting it on constantly can potentially increase your risk of getting more gray hair. So have a look, have a read through your shampoos and everything that you use, and make sure that it's containing ingredients that are safe to use within the hair. So the next part of this video is, how do we prevent gray hair? How do we stop getting gray hair? Is there anything we can do to stop getting gray hair or premature graying of the hair? Well, first of all, in terms of genetics, I'm sorry, there's nothing else we can do about that. If your genetics are like that, if you look at your mum, if you look at your dad, and you've noticed that actually they're telling you, I started graying when I was 25, then most likely you are going to be like that as well. It's going to be highly likely, if the two of them are like that, you're going to be like that as well. So there's not much else you can do in terms of stopping the gray hair. But we are going to discuss about other preventative stuff and other things that could potentially stop you from getting gray hairs. So please do continue watching the video, as some of them you might be able to relate to. So moving on to tip number one, which is all about diet and stress. So far in this video, I've been talking a lot about gut biome, and I told you I'm going to go through it in more detail now, okay? There haven't been any studies correlating gut biome with actual gray hairing, okay, with causing the gray hair. But there have been studies with diet-related stuff and eating healthier foods and making sure that we're having all the correct foods to get all the nutrients and vitamins that we need, okay? All of these are linked. So just by taking a vitamin supplement doesn't mean that you're going to get all the correct vitamins either. You need to get certain ones from your foods and eating healthy, okay? One of the things as well that we can do to make sure that we're absorbing everything correctly is by having the correct bacteria within our guts. The bacteria plays a massive role for various different things in the body. So making sure that our gut biome, so the gut bacteria, is all good and correct can be one of the most contributing factors. And unfortunately, as part of the diet that we have these days in the Western world, it can result in a really poor gut biome and potentially even causing dysbiosis, where the gut bacteria is all over the place, the bad bacteria is kind of overtaken, if you want to think of it like that. It's overtaken all the good bacteria, which leads to us not absorbing a lot of essential vitamins and stuff that we need, because we need bacteria to absorb a lot of stuff because it breaks down certain things, and the good bacteria does that for us. So they work in symbiosis, so they work together with the body. So in terms of your diet to help with your gut biome, definitely do some research. It's going to be really difficult for me to explain everything of what you need to do to help with your gut biome, but look at having a more healthy, balanced diet. One thing, for example, that doesn't help with the gut biome is a diet very high in gluten. So if you're having loads of things full of gluten, okay, maybe think about reducing it. This is going to help as well. If you're eating out all the time, if you're having takeaways, you know, 3 times a week, if you're having dirty food that's full of hydrogenated fats, if you're having processed meat, all of these things have been linked to making your gut biome worse. And that means that the bad bacteria increases, the good bacteria aren't doing well, and it's going to lead to these deficiencies that you won't even know about. So you need to make sure that you're kind of detoxing, basically. Have a deep think. Think about what you're eating and look it up, research about the gut biome, what you can do to help it, what kind of foods to eat, what kind of antioxidants to eat. Again, we spoke about oxidative stress as well. What kind of foods to eat that are antioxidants as well, like for example, pomegranates are great for that as well, and they help with your gut biome. They're a bit of a prebiotic as well. And there's loads of different things you can do. And again, stress as well. If you're stressing too much, like I said earlier, it's gonna cause harmful effects to the gut biome as well. So you need to look at different things as well that you can do to help with the stress, yoga, socializing, you know, these sort of things that you can just switch off, because these lives that we live these days, they are so stressful, we have so much going on, and all of these things are linked to the gut biome. There's so much research being done now on the gut bacteria and its links to different things. You know, recently, stress and anxiety disorders have been linked to it. Recently, cardiovascular diseases have been linked to it. So there's so many new things coming out. It's really, really impressive when I've been reading up about these, and I just wanted to make you all aware of it. So it's not 100% science that if you do this, it's gonna stop the gray hair, but there's definitely some links as well. There's definitely links at the moment with gut biomes and alopecia and hair loss and certain things like that as well. So all of these could potentially be linked as well with our diet and making sure that it's correct. I'm sorry if I've waffled on a lot. I hope that's made complete sense to you. You will need to do a bit of research as well, but I will try and leave some links and information in the description below as well. Now, moving on to tip number two. Tip number two is all about vitamin deficiencies. Do speak to your healthcare professional if you think you might be vitamin deficient. In the UK, for example, we recommend that everyone takes a vitamin D supplement, especially during the winter months where there's less sun, because most likely you're going to be vitamin D deficient, especially if you're doing jobs like an office job. We sat inside all day, you hardly see the sun. When you wake up, it's dark. When you come home, it's dark. Especially here in the UK, that's how it is during the winter months especially. You're not getting much sun, you're not getting that vitamin D. So vitamin D can be essential as well. That's one of the main vitamins that we promote here in the UK. But in different countries, it might be different. But one of the most important things is don't just go out and buy a load of vitamins without speaking to your healthcare professional first. Speak to your healthcare professional. They might do some blood tests for you as well to see if you're actually deficient in any of them. Remember as well, links to the gut biome. If your gut biome is working correctly, you will most likely get all the vitamins as well, because I did explain it a little earlier for you as well. Tip number three to stop gray hair, to stop that premature and gray hair. Okay, with tip number three, it's all about smoking. You need to quit, okay? It's as simple as that. Like we said, 2.5 times more likely to get premature graying. So if you do smoke, quit. If you really want to stop the gray hair and potentially reduce it, you need to quit smoking. And not only is it gonna help with the gray hair, it's gonna help with cardiovascular disease, it's gonna help with the various different cancers that it causes, it's gonna help with the poor skin, the aging, it's gonna help with that stink that everyone gets when they smoke. So please quit smoking. It's probably gonna be one of the best things you will ever, not probably, will be the best thing you ever do in your life if you do smoke. So, in terms of how to quit smoking, I do have a video on that topic, which I'll leave a link to up here and in the description below. Please watch it if you want more information on it, if you're a smoker, of course. And tip number four, make sure you do your own research as well. Look, there's lots of things out there when you Google it for gray hair remedies, and I don't know, slap an egg on your head or pour some turmeric on it. There's so many outrageous things out there. By the way, I'm not telling you to do any of them, okay, that can potentially stop gray hair, but just do your research, okay? Don't just go for whatever you read anywhere that anyone's telling you. You need to look at the research as well. So have a look on scientific websites. I'll actually link a journal website that I like to use in the description below for you, that, you know, if you're ever wondering if you want to read about sort of science, if you want to read through scientific journals about certain things that you might have read online, search it up on a journal website, or even actually just use Google Scholar. Google Scholar is really good for that sort of stuff. So I won't even need to link it actually. Just search Google Scholar on Google and it can do a big search for these topics and look at scientific papers. But most importantly, when you're looking at these papers, look at it like a scientist. Don't just think, it says, yeah, it works in the abstract. But look at how it was done. How was it performed? You know, how many participants did they have in it? Who funded it, most importantly? If I'm a company creating this drink, for example, that is going to stop gray hair, and I'm funding this research to be done on 2 people, and we're telling you that, yeah, it works great, then think about it. Like, is it actually a real research, or is it just being funded by a company to try and get this message out? So really do your due diligence. So it looks like we're coming to the end of the video. Like I said earlier, if you found any of this information helpful in this video, which I really hope you have, please do click that like button. I'd really appreciate it. And also, it's gonna help the video grow. It's gonna make it more popular for other people to see, and it's gonna help more people potentially, well, hopefully, okay? Because I know a lot of people will be searching how to stop gray hair, you know, how to prevent gray hair, what causes gray hair. So this video will be telling them everything they need to know about it. And I really hope you found this information helpful. Like I always say at the end of every single video, always remember you're awesome, and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.